أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وما توفيقي ولا اعتمادي إلا على الله عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا نظير له ولا مثال له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه وذريته وخلفائه الراشدين المرشدين المهديين من بعده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله تعالى واطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المنزل على لسان نبيه المرسل والسماء والطارق وما أدراك ما الطارق النجم الثاقب وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ياسين قلب القرآن صدق رسول الله. All believers, Alhamdulillah, we are here again for another Jum'ah. And Mawlana Shaykh Nazim is sending his blessings and his prayers and his du'as and his support. Alhamdulillah, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim supports each one of us in his own special way. Each one of us has a station to reach. Allah Almighty in His Holy Quran said, وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ وَاللَّهُ الَّذِي أَعْطَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَ ثُمَّ هَدَى. As Mawlana Shaykh Nazim teaches us that Allah Almighty in His Holy Quran said that Allah gave everything that He created. When we were created, Allah Almighty gave us from His endless mercy, life, from His gifts, grants. At that moment, we have something. Our duty here is to try to reach it. Is to try to reach that station. Whatever Allah Almighty granted you, you're not going to give it to Him. Whatever Allah Almighty granted him, He's not going to give it to his brother. Whatever his brother has, He's not going to give it to anybody. You are not going to take anything from anybody. You are going to take what Allah Almighty already gave you. You have something. Allah Almighty in his Holy Quran is saying, وَالسَّمَاءِ وَالطَّارِقِ. He is swearing by the sky. And He's swearing by the one that is knocking. وَالسَّمَاءِ. He's by the sky and by the one that is knocking, the knocker. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الطَّارِقِ. You don't know who is the knocker. How would you know who is knocking? And then Allah Almighty is continuing, النَّجْمُ الثَّاقِبِ. The one that is knocking is the star, the piercer, the piercing star. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. One of his holy names is Al-Najm Al-Thaqib, the star of creation. He is the best of creation. He is the most beautiful of creation. He is the most beloved of creation. He is the manifestation of Allah's love. Allah's love is manifesting on the Prophet ﷺ. He is the reception of that love coming down from Allah Almighty. We heard in one of the suhbas that was given by my uncle a few days ago that Sayyidina Musa, when he went to the mountain to ask for a drop, not even a drop, a 100th of a drop of love. And my uncle was saying that person, when Sayyidina Musa saw him, he was out. He was gone. No matter what you stick in him, no matter how many times you put swords, knives, daggers, bullets, no, he's gone. He's not around. That is 100th of a drop of love. What do you think of the Prophet where the love is falling on him?
Allahu Akbar.
He is the piercer. He is piercing. Piercing what? He has such love coming down on him that he is becoming such a powerful, powerful piercer going through the sky. That sky, the Allah Almighty is saying, this sky, how many skies? 700? Million? Billions? Like Mawlana Shaykh Nazim was telling us and teaching us all the time that there's no count to the skies. The skies are unlimited. Allah Almighty is giving that love to the Prophet, and the Prophet ﷺ is piercing through skies. One after another. He finishes one, knocks at the other. Finishes the other, knocks at the other. Keeps going. Why is he going? What is he trying to reach? The Prophet ﷺ. He's seeking his love. He is after his love. He is not stopping. he's hearing Allah Almighty saying, Ya Muhammad Galbaru, O Muhammad, come near. O Muhammad, come near. And the Prophet ﷺ is burning with that love, the manifestation of the love coming down on him, and he's piercing through the skies to reach his love. To reach his love. Allah Almighty. Ya Muhammad Galba. Ya Habibi. He's telling him, you are my beloved. You are my beloved. My love is on you. 1/100th of a drop of love made a person not aware of himself anymore. The Prophet ﷺ is piercing. And how do you pierce? What is the best way to pierce something? You rotate. You go fast and rotational. If when you are carving through a mountain, when you're going down a mine, the machine, the rotational machine that they have to dig through and pierce through is much quicker than digging and shoveling and going, rotation to reach his Lord Almighty. And what did Sayyidina Abu Bakr do? Sayyidina Abu Bakr, when he asked the Prophet ﷺ, when a companion of the Prophet asked him a question, and Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ said, you are with whom you love. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, we all know, started to rotate. You know that companions would do everything that the Prophet did. From the stories of the companions, we hear that the companions would take a certain road and do certain things because they saw the Prophet doing it. It doesn't make sense to people watching, and they ask, why did you go this way? Why did you do this? Why did you bend? Why did you sit? Why did you stand up? He said, I saw the Prophet doing it. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr saw the Prophet ﷺ rotating, piercing through the skies. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr rotated, following his love. Sayyidina Abu Bakr rotated, following his love. So Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ is rotating, piercing through the skies. And we are all rotating with him. Universes, galaxies, earth, sun, moon, everything with his whirlpool. When you have a ship and it's going like that, it sucks you in. You have a tornado that comes through, it sucks you up with it. And you rotate. You rotate in that tornado. So the Prophet ﷺ, he is the piercer rotating in the skies after his love. And all of us with his whirlpool rotating. The universes are rotating. He is our love. The Prophet ﷺ is our love. We cannot reach the love of Allah. We cannot reach the love of Allah. To reach the love of Allah, we have to follow the Prophet ﷺ. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فإن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني. If you love Allah, then follow me. That is, it explained so many times by our masters, but there's another explanation to it. You cannot follow the Prophet ﷺ. If you love Allah, you would be able to follow me. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, that's the condition. If you reach that station of love to Allah, then you can follow me. Then you can follow me. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, if you are at that station that you have the love of Allah, fattabi'uni, then it's okay, come follow me. Follow him where? إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني. Are we able to go up to the sky and knock the door? So how are we going to follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? Where is he? والسماء والطارق. By the sky and the one that's knocking on the door. If we are going to follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, then we'll be able to go up to the sky and knock on the door. Are we able to do that? Then we're not followers of the Prophet ﷺ. If you are able to elevate and be able to travel the space and reach the end of that space. No one knows where the end is. And reach the end of that space and knock the door for the first heaven. And after that, knock the door for the second heaven. And after that, knock the door for the third one, the fourth one, the fifth one, infinity. Then you are following the Prophet ﷺ. What we are doing, we are trying to elevate on earth. We are not trying to elevate in the skies. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وتلك الدار الآخرة نجعلها للذين لا يريدون علوا في الأرض. Allah Almighty is saying in the Holy Quran that hereafter, the Darul Akhirah, the hereafter, we make it for the people that do not want to elevate on earth. لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ. They do not want to be elevated on earth. They do not want to have positions on earth. They don't want to be something on earth. They want to elevate in the skies, following their love. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never wanted to be high on earth. Never. He never sought anything on earth. He always knocked at the door of the skies. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهٌ وَفِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهٌ. He is God. It is He that He is God on earth, and He is God in heavens, in the sky. Allah Almighty is saying فِي السَّمَاءِ. One. General concept. The sky. So inshallah we will be able to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his whirlpool, not by ourselves. We're not going to be able to knock anything by ourselves. In the whirlpool that he is going with that love and burn to Allah Almighty's call, come near. In that whirlpool, inshallah, we will be able to follow him to the presence of Allah Almighty. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه فهي فوزا للمستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شان صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد يا أيها المشتاقون لنور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين
آمين.
اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين
آمين.
اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين
آمين.
اللهم إنا نبايع ما بايعه سيدنا مولانا الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني
آمين.
إنا نبايع خليفة رسول الله من على هذا المنبر
آمين.
اللهم انصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا قريبا
آمين.
اللهم اجعل لنا من لدنك وليا اللهم اجعل لنا من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا واكتب الصحة والسلامة والعفو والعافية علينا وعلى الحجاج والركاب والزوار والمجاهدين في سبيل الله في بحرك وبرك وجوك من أمة محمد أجمعين وسلام على المرسلين خصوصا على سيد المرسلين وسلامة على الحاضرين والمؤمنين والغائبين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون